So the e-portfolio works a bit like a digital resume, so that when you are on the labor market, you have an electronic record of your the accomplishments that you've done over your 4 years that you're most proud of. And so it's like a digital storyboard or story of you and the things that you're most excited about or most proud of. So over the course of your 4 years, things like really big writing samples or art pieces or performances, those are the sorts of things that you want to include. So it becomes part of a whole narrative of who you are. And they really can be make it or break it opportunities for jobs. So if you're thinking about applying for any particular job and you just say, here you can find a digital portfolio of my work, you can, the other thing that you can do is track who, depending on what the platform, you can track who use it. So you're seeing who you're getting traction with in terms of employers before you would even get an interview with somebody. But it is a really interesting way of saying, like, here's who I am. Here's some of exemplars of my work to help round out a larger story about you for a job market. Also grad school.
And the e-portfolio goes with you when you leave Randolph-Macon. So it's something that you can take with you. Anything else? We sent you a document by email just a little bit ago with the deadlines, with specific items about what you should put in your e-portfolio based on whether you're in your first, second, or third year at Randolph-Macon. If you're in your first year, the requirements are very minor. I think we ask you to make your pages and maybe put your one paragraph bio and put one item on there. As you progress, you will add more items, and every year you'll send us a link so that we can take a look at it. Anything else?
Nope.
All righty. So we will be quiet and let Mrs. Young from the library speak to you.
Hey, everyone. Thank you for having me. I'm so glad that so many of you are here. This probably is by far the biggest crowd I've had since the pandemic started, which is great. Okay, so as professors Marcetti and Cripps have explained, that the e-portfolio will be a great way to document your growth. It will also be a great way to showcase what you have accomplished. Additionally, being savvy with production and use media outlet is almost a requirement for today's workforce. However you present yourself, what to present and how to organize the information that will make the information attractive to the target audience. In your case, might be graduate school or the workforce, like the employers. So I'm going to go ahead and start with a quick activity, so everybody will get to participate. Assuming you have your computer in front of you, or if you have your phone or iPad, you could access some of the information, but without the app downloaded, it will be hard. So ideally, you have your computer. All right, so I'm going to share my screen. And occasionally, when you see my mouse jumping around on the screen, that's because I'm moving the control bar or the video display, the gallery view out of way. That's just a weird thing about using Zoom. Sometimes you see people's mouse and you don't know what the mouse is moving around. Okay, so I'm going to paste this URL in the chat room so that you can go there. If you have your phone, you can point to the QR code. But again, without the app, you wouldn't be able to do much. You can go to the website. So in the, in the chat space. All right, again, I'm moving stuff around. All right, so let me stop share for now. Okay, so I'll send to everyone. Okay. So you can follow this link and you can go to the document, and please log in using your Randolph-Macon username and password. So this actually will take you to the Google Doc, everybody at Randolph-Macon has a space on Google. It's sponsored by Randolph-Macon. It allows unlimited storage, which is wonderful because you're going to use that storage for your portfolio and some other projects, and best yet, to store, for instance, your media, your images. And usually, so far, we're still keeping students Randolph-Macon Google account after they graduate. At some point, and it depends on the policy set by Google, we might ask people to back up the Randolph-Macon Google account to their own personal Google account. But as of now, yes, you can go to that space. If you have logged in, I'm gonna share the screen again. Okay, so basically that space is, okay, if I go there, copy, and I'm going there too. Oh. All right. So this is a blank document that I'm going to ask you to type in three words or phrases that come to you when people mention portfolio. We sort of already talked a little bit, but think about, you know, why, how, what. Okay, if you could just enter three words or phrases, and we're gonna see what it looks like. Yes, just click on any of the lines and start typing. Right, so I'm scrolling partially because I don't want people to look at one single person typing, right? So we just know that things are coming, still typing. Okay, and yeah, so yeah, we'll have one more minute to think and type, and then we'll see what people have, what we come up with. Okay. All right. And if you continue typing, that's fine. But I'm going to just quickly generate something that you see what we have. Okay, so we'll get a cloud going. I hope this will work, because yesterday when I was trying it, it stuck. Okay, so there we go. All right, this is what we have. This is what you have typed in. It seems like the biggest words, okay? This is a resume. Yes, definitely the e-portfolio will be helpful. It will be enhancement to your resume. It will make your resume look strong. At least if it's well-designed, people will know that you're good at media and multimedia production. Okay, and now there's work. Okay, so we got 10 people type that. So resume definitely is the highest frequency, and jobs. Okay, so it seems like we all have some idea about, you know, what we're gonna use this for, use the e-portfolio for. That's great. So moving back to our presentation. So that's our activity. We saw the cloud. Okay, so just based on what we quickly went through and the handout that the honors directors gave you. Okay, so what actually, why would we want to use ePortfolio or make ePortfolio? So to document your growth and also reflection and the connection. We would like you to think about making the connection between things you learned and also through the years. So it's great that you start the process in freshman, okay? And also, well, we know that a well-rounded student, Randolph-Macon student, or just a good citizen, okay, it's not just your school life. Sometimes your personal and even community life should be intersect with what you learn in school, the service part, okay? Right. And to do that, okay, we have multitude of tools. And for the requirement, the assignment, you are going to have the biography page, which is the self-introduction page. And also you are expected to include some kind of project, ideally like writing, you know, your performance, your research, your art project, and so on and so forth. Okay, so we have a lot of resources at Randolph-Macon for everybody and for definitely for honor students. And if you know that the library actually has some special services for the honors program, including the specialized liaison librarian, and the makerspace or my office located in the library will be is open, but is at limited capacity, you know, by appointment. But we have the programs, okay? Some you're already using on computer, PowerPoint, you know that. You can record your voice and then you can convert that to MP4. Audacity, well, it's available. It's free for you to download. And Adobe Spark is a program that I would encourage you to take advantage of. It's very easy. It's got lots of stock images free for you to use, okay, to create your own infographics, for instance, and even make videos or just like a presentation, what we have now, but it's very graphic savvy and it comes with many professional designed templates. So that's Adobe Spark. And by the way, I will send this I'll share the presentation with Drs. Marcetti and Chris so that you have access to when you click on the link. Okay, the library, McGraw-Page Library has a student resources page. It has, you know, how you use the program, where are they, and so on and so forth. And this piece of information that I would encourage you to check out is the Creative Commons. I believe all college students should have knowledge of Creative Commons. Okay, we know that we have very strict copyright law. All right, so when you include some media on your webpage and your webpage could potentially be viewable by the whole world, we have to pay close attention to fair use and copyright. Okay, and Creative Commons could actually tell you how it's copyrighted. And we are not going to go through all of them, but I would like you to go ahead and go to Google. Okay, I'm gonna do the same thing with you. Okay, so we're going to use Google Advanced Search to quickly see how we get to the copyright-free media. Okay, so let me get out. All right, so I'm just gonna use this screen. Okay, so if you do image search, we probably have been doing that all the time, right? So you can search for something. Okay, for instance, yellow jacket. Okay, all right. Yellow jacket indeed. So if you go ahead and click on settings and then click on advanced search, and I would like you to do that. I cannot see your screen, but I hope that you all follow along. So usage rate instead of all, instead of all, let's select Creative Commons licenses and then do advanced search. Okay, so does that mean that these are all copyright free? Probably not, but at least you can click on it and follow it. It will tell you how it's licensed. Okay. All right, so just, I wanna bring to your attention, you know, Google search and Creative Commons license. Definitely you can go directly to Creative. Okay, let me just click on that. Okay, for instance, this photo. All right, it says, okay, you can get this image. You wanna know more information about this, but let me just click on the link. It probably will tell me that how I can use it. Okay, so I'm clicking this away. Okay. All So whatever you have, chose to search, it probably will tell you. Okay, so my computer is very slow, kind of lagging. Okay, so it tells you how you can use it. In this case, that actually some rights reserved. You can click to see what rights are reserved. It takes you to Creative Commons. Okay, basically it says, yes, you are free to share. Okay, copy and redistribute in any format, and you know, in printout on web page, you can remix. All right, so you can repurpose even commercially. So this one is very, very liberal, very, it's almost like free for you to use. But there are some, it will say you have to give, you have to attribute, you have to give credit. Let me see if this, yeah, it says you have to like cite or provide links to this image. So basically, I just want you to be aware that Creative Commons is an important tool for you to use when you use media that you don't own in your web page. Okay. All right. So I'm going to stop share so that I could just see everybody. And if you have questions, I could see. If you want to raise your hand, I'm going to scroll screen, see if I see any hands up. Okay. All right. So I'll continue. I'll share the screen again. Okay. So so that's the resources you actually can go to, but be aware that even some pages say, oh, you can use it. It might say, well, you can only use it for education. In our case, that's fine. But there are other places that might say you cannot remix, meaning you cannot alter whatever images there. You cannot crop, you cannot change like the lighting, the colors, so on and so forth. Okay, so without further ado, we're going to start our site, Google site. Okay, so the Google site that I have quickly did as an example. Okay, so just close all that stuff. Okay, so this is a sample site, okay. I have an introduction page, and I actually have, I have the categories that people can get to. In my case, I have decided that I'll use these headings, okay. Academics, civil engagement, and leadership. You can choose your own categories or topics or headings, okay. But the way it works is, okay, so people click on academics. Okay, so I have, all the academic activities, and I also have the academics organized into three categories. Okay, writing samples, study abroad, internships. Okay, I would use a lot of images, especially for things like, internships. If I, did some internships, say in the local, minority groups or immigrant groups, I probably would have pictures taken. Okay, and civil engagement being another, and I actually included some YouTube videos here. Okay, and leadership. So that's the organization of my webpage. And for you, I would encourage you to follow the guidelines that the honors program has distributed. So for freshmen through, the upperclassmen, the honor students, what to include, how you organize. And of course, it has a lot to do with, what you want to highlight. And you probably could change and move things around throughout your Randolph-Macon career. Like, freshmen, you'll have something, and later you actually want to highlight your leadership or civil engagement. And higher up, if you are planning to go to graduate school, you probably want to highlight your research and you want to create another heading. Okay, so to do that, I'm going to close a few tabs so that my computer will not be crowded. Okay, to do that, if you have already logged in to Google, go ahead and click on Google Drive. Okay, and that's where I'm now. Okay, so in your Google Drive, go ahead and click new and select folder. Let's create a Google folder in a drive and name it ePortfolio. And that's what I have here. Say in my drive, I have ePortfolio. And if you want to create a folder and call it ePortfolio or Honors Program ePortfolio, however you want to name it. Okay, so sorry about that. My mouse is stuck. Okay. Okay. All right, so in the folder, I want to make sure that all my information related to the portfolio, ePortfolio, will be in this folder. And the reason is you will have a lot of information, a lot of documents, a lot of images, and probably some other things such as your PDF files, right? Your photos and the infographics you created, like, you know, the brochure to promote some information in, to promote some events or activities that are involved in. So you will have a lot of files for the project, the ePortfolio project. You want to actually put all of them in the same space, just so that it's easier for you to move things and find things. And in my case, I also created an image folder just because I decided to use a lot of images. So when I click, it probably should be called media sample instead of image sample because I have all the images and I also have links to the YouTube videos. Okay, all right, so that said, we will go ahead and click on new and select more and select Google Sites. Google Sites is the program that we will use for the development of our ePortfolio. So it is a web page, a website. It starts with the home page. Okay. That's just, you can put your name, or if you have a headline or a tagline for your web page, you could do that too. But in my case, I'm just going to, I'm just gonna use my name. It could be, Okay, so the homepage itself is not that exciting, right? So it's just black and black header, white space. You can customize it by selecting the image for the header. Okay, so I don't imagine you already have a lot of images. Okay, so I'm going to have Chelsea enter the room. Okay, so in your case, you probably don't already have images, which is fine. We can just use a stock image. Let's go ahead and click on change image. Okay, you can upload, but I'm gonna select. Okay, as I said that Google has some free images. Just for demonstration, I'm gonna pick this one. But if you already have some images, you can upload. And when I do it, I would much rather have all the images, related images, upload to that space in Google Drive. Two people. Okay. So I would actually have images all upload into the same folder that I have created just for the portfolio project. It's like what I said, it's easier to, you know, to find things, to delete things. I just like to get things organized. Okay, so in this case, I'm just gonna randomly pick an image and then hit select. Okay, there we go. So when I select image, Google will change the color of the text, and that is for usability. Your website will be viewed by people who may potentially have colorblind issues or vision issues. Well, the percentage of visually impaired people actually is pretty high. So we want to make sure that we follow the usability and universal design principles. And in our case, when we use Google Sites, Google actually used the artificial intelligence to detect if your text will stand out against the background. So if you pick a picture which is very dark, Google probably will turn the text into white. But in my case, it's a light background. So that Google has selected very dark font color for me. Okay, so that's the header. So I would like to, again, I cannot see you or your screen. And if I'm moving too fast, feel free to just, let's see, what's the best way for you to, I think you can just post an image or just voice out, ask me to, excuse me, I can slow down. Okay, all right. So at this point, we have the front page. Okay, it's just a page. It doesn't have any content. But before we get to the content, okay, let's get organized a little bit. Okay, how I'm going to structure my ePortfolio. To do that, let's click on pages. Okay, as of now, it says there's one page, which is the home page. Okay, let's create another page, however you want to call it. Okay, and like what I said, however you want to highlight, or what is in the requirement of your ePortfolio project. Okay, you create another page for that. Click on the plus sign. You get to add a new link or add a new page. In our case, it's a new page. So let's go ahead and click on that. Okay. So I'm going to just use academics, all right? So academics could be, learning, research paper, writing samples, or my, for instance, theater production, so on and so forth. Okay, or even could be the honors courses that I've taken. I'm just going to hit done. So there we go. Now you have homepage and academics, and it shows on the, I guess the navigation bar, we'll call it navigation bar. Okay, it shows when people or your viewer, your audience click on home, it comes to homepage. When they click on academics, it comes to the academics page. So let's just do one more. Okay, we'll add another page. And I'll call it community service. Hit done. All right, okay. So what if I want academics to come before community service? Okay, if you use Google Chrome, and by the way, if you use anything related to Google, Chrome is definitely the best browser, okay? If you use Safari right now, I think you can still do it, but if you have problem doing it, I wouldn't be surprised, because Safari gets updated so often. Sometimes it's the web browser, sometimes it's the MacBook, the operating system. So it could change, but Chrome will allow you to move up and down. But when you click on item, grab and move. So that's how you can move things, okay. All right, so when I was doing that, I accidentally indented it. Okay, so, but anyway, you can move that up and down so that the categories will appear in the correct order or the order you want it. So these are pages, okay? And then you will just go to the page and start to fill the content. Okay, you'll go to the page and start to add content. And we'll come to the content in just a little bit. As of now, okay, so if you look to the right, this is where you can insert the layout, the content, and so on and so forth. Pages will be all the pages that make up the website, and all the pages can display here. Okay, let's take a look at themes. Google doesn't offer a whole lot of themes, although programmers can program their own themes. Okay, basically you have simple, Aristotle, okay, all these. And part of the themes thing, okay, there aren't many, is because of this, again, universal design. Scalability, okay, however you add the content, whatever layout you choose, it should all display nicely when people use a desktop, a laptop, an iPad, or a phone, right? So Google provides all the free layout so that your page will appear, or your website will display friendly, very friendly to whoever users or whatever devices they use. Okay, so again, you pick a theme. You can, sorry, my mouse is just giving me all that. Okay, so you pick a theme. Well, can you change, like, do you have any flexibility, for instance, to change the font, the size, the colors? Yes, you do. But basically, the choices will be, you can change the size, you can change the font, and you could probably just change a little bit about the bar. Sorry, like the color right now is sort of gold. If you, if you pick a whatever color bar, it does change a little bit on the bottom. So just so you know that the themes are, there aren't many of them, but to sort of customize your website or the look, you can change the header image. Okay. All right. So, okay, now let's click on home, click on homepage. This is when, when Professor Marcetti mentioned that if you have your laptop with you, your computer with you, you can start to actually get quite a bit accomplished today with your portfolio. Okay, so if you already have your biography page, in a Word document or what have you, you can copy and paste it here. Okay, but before we do that, let's go ahead and click on insert. Let's take a look at the layout options we have. So what you can do is you can, for instance, click on this layout. Oh, dear, my mouse. Okay, so yeah, okay, click on the layout. And this is where you can add images, right? Yourself, or it could be a formal picture, but it can also be, for instance, community service that you know, the picture you're very proud of. Okay, so if I remember, I have saved some images in my folder, the ePortfolio folder. Okay, so, all right. And I just want to let you know that I basically lifted image from the Honors Program website, the Randolph-Macon official website. Okay, so yeah, I mean, obviously these students are, I'm not one of them. I'm just using this as an example. Okay, so I have the image and I'm going to say, okay, so introduction or about me. And this is where you can start typing or copy and pasting. Okay, so that's one page. Okay, before I move away, I would like you to just type in something. I'm for instance, a freshman. I would like you to try make a link, Randolph-Macon College. So when people click on Randolph-Macon College, the audience will actually be taken to a college website. Okay, so let's see how we do that. So to do that, we'll highlight the text and as if you were doing it in PowerPoint, right? So we click that. Okay, and the link being, it's much easier if you could just copy and paste the website, but you have to have the complete website, not just rmc.edu. Okay. So to test if it works, Okay, we'll have to put it in the preview mode. Let's go ahead and click the icon on the top, sort of to the right. It has that preview icon. Let's click on that. Okay, so it probably defaults to a computer preview, but you can scroll, I mean, you can pick what it looks like on the phone, on a tablet, and on the computer. And when you and when you're on the preview mode, when you click on Randolph-Macon College link, it takes me to Randolph-Macon College. Okay. Oops, sorry. All right. Okay. So yeah, it opens a new tab, by the way. You can close that. So that's how you link to a new website. For instance, if you belong to a club, okay, or some professional organizations, at one point, if you link to that, this is how you would do that. So accept. So that's your homepage. And next we're going to, add a little bit more under just as demonstration, okay? So what if you want people to contact you? Okay, you have your contact information. So I suggest you add footer. This will appear on every page, just like, you know, page number when you insert it on a Word document. So that's, you know, okay, that's footer. Okay, what if you want to put a little bit more on the web page, on the home page, or it could be on any page. Let's just see what the other elements that or other in layout we could use. Okay, so you can actually for instance do an image carousel, for instance. Academics, if you study abroad. Let's just go ahead and go to academics then. Okay, so in academics, okay. Yeah, you can talk about, you know, the courses that, you know, that influenced you in a big way or helped you improve things like critical thinking, empathy, so on and so forth. You could do that, but what if you want to put study abroad? First of all, under academics, you can add a subheading. Okay, let's do that by clicking on pages. Okay, so under academics, right? I'm going to click on the three dots, and I want to add a subpage. Okay, add a subpage, and I'll call it study abroad. Select done. Okay. And now in your menu bar, you see that little caret because it has a subpage. So when you click on study abroad, you're on study abroad. Okay, so you can have narratives. Anytime you want to add text, you can just double click and the menu spin, the wheel will show up and you can just click on, okay. So you can type, you know, I spent, you know, 3 weeks and okay, so okay, so if you type something and then you can add, for instance, the carousel. Okay, so it's like a gallery. And in my case, I'm going to just, if you go ahead and click on insert. All right, so that's to insert some elements. When you click on image carousel, you can start to create carousel. You can upload image or select image. And in my case, I'm just gonna do I'm gonna select all these images. One. Okay, add another. Okay, and if I hit insert, so there's my carousel and you can resize it, by the way. Okay, so that's my carousel. And if you look at it from the gallery view, I mean, from the preview, you can just scroll that through and that's what your audience will see. So that's done. Okay, all right, so let's go back to homepage. At this point, for instance, okay, you're like, okay, so what is this untitled site? You can give it a title, you know, Lady Sounds portfolio, or, you know, however you want to name it. So give it a name. Okay. All right. So on pages, I want to point out something. Since this is a portfolio that you will build, contribute, and make changes to throughout your Randolph-Macon college career, there are times you might think, oh, you know what? Maybe the study abroad, okay, in my case, it's just an example. Maybe study abroad, I don't actually want to display for now. Or if I'm applying for graduate school, okay, for the fourth year, when I'm applying for graduate school, but I'm also looking for jobs, okay, because I just want to keep the options open. Well, what if at some point I don't actually want to show too much because you don't want to cluster the website either, right? If you have a lot of headings here, okay, what if I want to hide some? You can do that by going to going to pages first. I want to hide the page. So click on the menu, okay, and hide from navigation so that it will be, your navigation will not be too clustered. Okay. So you can, it's not that it is inaccessible. You can still go there and I'll show you how. Okay. But it's not showing up as in the navigation. Okay. What about, okay, so the page information is there, but it's not showing up on navigation. Okay, let's just add another line. Okay, so. Okay, to do that, you can highlight, oops, I'm gonna not use my mouse, I just use the pad. Okay, so you can highlight the words that you're gonna make a link. Okay, and still click on the link, right? Just like add a link. And then Google displays the pages that you can link to. And in my case, it's study abroad. And I'll hit apply. Okay, so to preview it. All right, study abroad is not accessible from the navigation menu, but it is accessible from the link that I want people to go to. Okay, so I provide the access. It's not through the navigation, but just from somewhere in my text on the homepage. Okay, so basically, you know, that's all we need, right? We have the layout, we have the images, we have text. I'm gonna stop sharing and I wanna ask you a question. Okay, so all the images, right? So you use, hopefully many of them are your images or images that, you know, the honors program provide. And still it's good to give credit for, you know, for using images that you get from the college website. Okay, so you give credits to the images. What if you want to make a link to, for instance, a YouTube video? Do you need to make sure that it's you have the right to link to a YouTube video? Do you think you have the right to do that, or you have to like think about copyright? We're talking about just making a link to the YouTube video. What do you think? Okay, all right. So it's okay to make a link to any page, to any web page, or even to a YouTube video, okay, without worrying about copyright, because it is public. It is public domain, just like a street name, okay? You cannot claim copyright to a street name. So the web address, okay? When the web address itself is public, people can choose to hide some content on that web page, but the web address itself is public. So it's free for you to link to. Okay? All right. I'm gonna share again. So just so community service. Here I want to actually insert a video. All right, so what I'll do is first on my, I have the link already saved in my Google Doc. Okay, so I'm gonna copy that and I will come to the webpage. Okay, and here I will, I will insert YouTube video. To do that, go ahead and go to insert and under, as that's YouTube, and I'll paste that. And search, click on that and select. Okay, so that's how you insert YouTube video. And I think that many of you probably will need to do that, especially now we're doing a lot of video and social media. So it's good that you if you're involved in community service and has a Facebook and a video, it's great to link it that way. Okay, so that's how to link a video. Now it comes to the last point of my presentation is to publish. Okay, the good thing about using Randolph-Macon Google, not your personal Google, is that you can actually publish just to the Randolph-Macon community. All right, so which is understandable, especially for the beginners. As part of the honors program requirement, you start to develop portfolio. You don't want the whole world to see it yet. Okay, you want to start to build something, but when you have enough confidence, when you think that the content is great, okay, you will want other people to see. But as of now, you just want to publish to Randolph-Macon community. To do that, okay, you'll go ahead and click on publish, right? It does ask you to give it give a name so that you will have unique URL. So your website or your ePortfolio URL will always start with sites.google.com, goarmc.edu. Okay, that's part of the Randolph-Macon domain. And you can make it long or you can make it, it doesn't have to really sound portfolio. You could just type your full name. But if you decide that, this website doesn't look good, I don't like it, then you just have to pick a different, different URL or different domain name, because all web addresses are unique. Okay, so you cannot use, for instance, a little example portfolio. I think I already used it somewhere. That's what it says, that it's already taken. You cannot use it. And even if it belongs to you, you cannot use it. It has to be unique. Okay, so how about Lily's house? Right, that doesn't, okay. Anyway, that's unique and it allows me to publish. So when I hit publish, okay. All right. Okay, you can hit publish settings. Okay, as of now, okay, so it says okay. You have to review it and hit save. Okay, as of now, it's published. View published sites. Okay, you can take a look at view published sites. That's what your audience will truly see. So without those little icons in a computer or iPad, iPhone kind of icon. So you can see what the audience will really see. All right, so click on that, you know, so they brought, so on and so forth. Okay. I also want to point out that publish is a little different from share. When you click on the share button, that's actually you can let, for instance, your professors edit. Okay, so if you, if you publish site, that's the default. Okay, if you want your professors to edit for you, your biography, or if you want people to edit it, this is where you can invite them to edit. Okay. So that's the share part, and publish by default, it goes to the Randolph-Macon College community, but when it's completely ready for publishing to the whole world, you can change to just like default, unrestricted publishing. So, that's all I have for the ePortfolio development. So I would encourage you to organize the information beforehand, how to structure, what are the big categories and headings you want to use, what would be included under that heading, gather enough media, including images. And it's important that when you do things that you sort of want to document, right, by taking images. So gather enough images. And then the writing samples, okay, that if you feel proud of, you can copy and paste, or you could just post a PDF. For productions or your artwork, images are important. So be sure to take a lot of photos. The media is an important part on a web page. So if your page has nothing but text, usually it's not as interesting. So place images strategically. If you have gallery, image gallery, share them.